Pochettino should go to MLS, bro.
Bro,
he'll become God in MLS. Pochettino might enter Miami and like he'll win everything, whatever there to win. But yeah,
we will be discussing the most overrated players from some of the top Premier League teams and see which players, according to these boys, get the not so envious tag of being overrated. Let's start with Tottenham.
Where do I start? Where do I start?
Tottenham Hotspur and why Ange is the answer.
I have five.
Can we answer Ange, by the way?
Yeah, go ahead. You deserve it.
We're thinking of
other people.
Yeah,
there are so many.
Poro,
Udogi, Ange, Bissouma, Richarlison, Brendan Johnson, Mickey van de Ven. James Maddison. Timo Werner is fine.
Timo Werner is underrated.
Underrated.
How bad he is underrated. Yeah. People don't rate him how bad he is.
But if I want to select one out of all of these,
I would the entire Spurs squad, bro.
True Arsenal hatred, bro.
I know. It's best. They don't even deserve to be mentioned in the same breath as Arsenal, bro. Don't have to hate them so much.
No. It's not about hate. Yeah, think about this, right? Overrated. What is the definition of overrated?
I think Poro and Rudogi are properly rated. Like,
yeah,
only, I think they're only rated very this. High for how defensively that they've struggled so hard. Like,
I mean, the thing is, as rival fans, you guys also appreciated those two players at some point. So yeah. I think that is enough rating.
I'll give you.
Maybe you can also do Tottenham defense. If you want to, like, if you just can't decide.
Actually,
on one
I really like Mickey van de Ven, so no, I wouldn't go for van de Ven. I'm gonna go actually for Vicario, because he was rated really highly, and he's shipped in like 45 goals. He shipped in goals going right, and people haven't noticed, but he shipped in really easy goals. Like it's from the start of the season, hype was too high for Vicario. It was just like he's better than every goalkeeper. He's done this, he's done that. Overrated.
He's also a little bit tough in the air, like catching corners.
Yeah, he started at a lot of things, bro. Like
he had a dip. I think he was good in those first few games that we saw where everyone, Tottenham fans went nuts when we did that Kerala Spurs thing.
Yeah.
There was that phase, you remember?
Yeah.
And I think after that he had a dip, like a bad dip, and like it just went under the radar.
But do you think this is because of Spurs' playstyle and how high of a line they play, and like they invite more shots? And
yeah,
like
so
a keeper is bound to make more mistakes.
That way only I'm saying he's overrated.
I think it's also down to injuries. Like a lot of they face a lot of shots because of injured players. So also reason. But like Nihal, who's your Spurs overrated player?
Yeah, I was gonna pick between Vicario and Brennan Johnson, but I'm okay with Vicario. Because I agree with the dip. Like because after the first five games I think there was nothing that we saw of him. Like there was this one game where he was mad good. I
Johnson
is
also good shout. Liverpool
against
game, he was
us,
good. Remember, 4-1
against
they lost.
In the first half, he made some mad saves.
Yeah. Even the Liverpool game when they were 9 men down or something, he lost 4-1, but still, they were rating his brilliance and his warrior-ness or whatever.
Yeah.
So, do you have a different one?
No, I'll pick Brennan Johnson.
Okay, that's a good one.
We'll go with Vicario then. Before we continue further, if you're enjoying the content, please leave a comment and tell us your favorite part of the video. Don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel. We have loads of such things lined up and we're excited to share it with you. Okay, next team, West Ham. Underrated, most overrated player.
Boring.
What
did I write?
Can we pick Calvin Phillips?
No. I mean, he's not overrated anymore. I think he's not rated by anybody anymore.
No, but he's also on loan. That's why I was saying, like, technically a City, but...
No, you can pick him if you want to, but I don't think he's rated.
I'd pick Calvin Phillips.
Yeah, I'll also click. Let's get this over with. I don't want to talk about West Ham.
Yeah, I just finish it off, man.
Calvin Phillips. Nihal, Calvin
somebody
Phillips.
Jared Bowen. I'm going to put Jared Bowen on there.
Okay, you take it. Let's all switch to Jared Bowen so we can get done with this.
Unai Emery. Aston Villa.
I'm going to say Martinez. I'm going to say Dibu, because Dibu has just been overrated since the World Cup. He's been given the best goalkeeper of the year awards and stuff like that. I know he made one amazing save, which probably he has a big banner of that in his bedroom. He made that legendary save, I understand. It was more shit from Colomani, in my opinion. He could have, like, it was Colomani, right? I think,
Yeah.
He could have, like, scored that goal.
123rd minute, right?
Yeah. He had really good. Yeah. Sorry, go ahead.
No, no, the last kick of the game. Like, I would.
He had good. He was good in the.
I think after that celebration, he's busy holding his own dick, bro. Like, that's
he couldn't control, bro. He was just about to jizz all over the place. But,
Yeah, no, he's...
Yeah, I mean, Martinez is good. I would also pick this guy, Moussa Diaby.
Ooh, nice shot.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Like, you bought him for 60 million. Like, oh, exciting player, this, that. But what has he done? Like, he's been pretty much invisible, right?
True. He got benched by Leon Bailey, who was basically already on the bench. So,
yeah.
That's a good one, too. I'm okay with any of these two.
Yeah. I just have a shocker. I think I expected a lot more from Tielemans, but they got them for free and he didn't do shit.
Fuck, dude. So I have so many. I just realized.
Also, I want to say a fuck you to Douglas Lewis for that celebration that he did against us, but like, that's just pure hatred.
He's a good player, though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, last club. Nihal's favorite. Let's go, Chelsea.
Ooh.
Moises Caicedo.
So full squad. Full squad. Let's go.
Enzo. Nicholas Jackson, dude. He is the most overrated player by all the Chelsea.
Nobody rates him, bro. Nobody rates him.
Ask Chelsea Pakistan.
He rates himself. He compared himself to Drogba, man. Like, Drogba took time in the initial years.
If you have to pick one, the Caicedo hype was just too high.
Yep.
Caicedo. At least at minimum, Enzo did something in the World Cup. And Enzo still had some moments in the game where he's looked good. Caicedo just hasn't looked like he's settled. He just hasn't looked like anything of a 100 million fucking player, dude. But Chelsea just has too many.
Well, in a parallel universe, you have Mudrik and Caicedo instead of
Fuck that parallel universe.
I have that as a conversation topic for a pod. But like,
yeah.
I think they would have done great, to be honest. I won't lie. Because I just trust Arteta to use them.
We will never know.
Yeah.
We might know with mood.
So much talk about talent ID and like we barely talk about these like beautiful misses. Nirav.
But
that's Chelsea's fault. Arsenal didn't want to go above a set price. So that is also like a hold. Like it's not like Antony. You went in for 50. Ajax is like 50 million. You're like, yeah, cool.
I mean,
and then you come back sometime later. They're like 80 million now. They're like, okay, what else? Give.
Don't fool yourself in thinking that you were not close to that price tag. You were bidding 80 million. You were bidding like 60 something for Mudrik. Yeah. So that is still a high price. Like you
did not have enough
money to break that ceiling. That doesn't mean that like his talent ID is spotless.
Yeah.
Caicedo, yes. Caicedo is the...
You lucked out, man.
I can still say Mudrik would have been a fucking hit at Arsenal. He still can be a hit at Chelsea. He can be a baller player. I don't consider him as underrated or overrated at all. I think he can be a baller player. He's just not polished enough. He needed a better stable team to go into. And I think Arteta had a plan for him. But Caicedo just looks sus, dude. Like, honestly.
I mean, I can say the very same thing for Caicedo, right? Like, I mean, Arteta wanted him. We basically got paid whatever they wanted, but they didn't want to sell in January. But then Klopp went for him with a lot of money. Mm. So you can't...
You cannot. Yeah. Klopp, fucking Liverpool, FSG went 100 million from you. Just cannot. You know he's a good player just fucking around. But I'll still call him overrated.
I think let's change this to just Chelsea hierarchy or like the club. The answer. But anyway, that was...
Pochettino also overrated.
Pochettino is definitely...
Quite overrated. Nothing is Pochettino done in life, but just overrated.
Pochettino should go to MLS, bro.
Bro.
He'll become God in MLS.
Bro, I have one shot.
Pochettino at Inter Miami and like he'll win everything, whatever there to win, but yeah. Sorry.
Bro, AJ, I have one shot, bro. Iska bhai, Raheem Sterling, bro.
I'm telling you, Chelsea has a team of overrated players. My God.
Yeah.
But you know, you know what? Funny thing is, Sterling now is not rated because he's not selected for the England setup too. So he's properly like gone down. Rashford at least is selected for that.
Yeah.
Yeah, Rashford is still overrated. Yeah.
Kiska bhai? Sabki jaan, meri jaan. Kiska bhai?
Kiska bhai?
Sabka ek bhai jaan. Sterling bhai.
Okay, so that was a wrap. Let us know what you guys think are the most overrated players in these teams.